It's official. Kapil Sharma got married to Ellie Avram. Well, yes or no? Anyways, we all know the two are shooting for Abbas Mustan's Kiss Kiss Ko Pyar Karun, right? So it doesn't come as a surprise that the two got married on the sets of the film. While Salman Khan and Ellie may not be getting married in real life, but Kapil and Ellie got married in real life. Few details are known about the plot of the film, but Kapil's debut movie is going to be amazing as the two are set to sizzle the screen with their insane chemistry. We just can't wait to see it all play out on screen. What do you think, peeps? Are you excited to see Kapil and Ellie scorch the 70mm screen? Your thoughts are as always most welcome. Sanjay Leela Bhansali's upcoming flick Bajirao Mastani is indeed going to be a musical treat. Starring Ranveer Singh, Priyanka Chopra and Deepika Padukone, the film will have 10 songs and we will also get to see Miss Chopra and Dippy Babies dance off in the movie. But what's more is that each of the actors will have solo numbers and then Bhansali is going to incorporate a grand song featuring all three of them. Now this is something to watch out for as the three are good at dancing, no? There will be one song wherein Ranveer will romance Deepika and there will be a different track wherein he will romance Priyanka. Knowing Sanjay Leela Bhansali, we are damn sure he will do complete justice to the grand number. Who does not wish to see Salman Khan again and again? Practically all his fans would go gaga if his movies were shown in the theatre. Lately, our Khufiya Jasoos has been going around in the Salman camp and brings us this news about his upcoming sequels. Hey, that's interesting, Anna. Obviously, if it is Salman, it would be Dabang 3, Bodyguard 2, Kick 2 and No Entry 2. Whoa, what a feast it would be for the filmy janta. Salman would start in any of this only after his Bajrangi Bhaijaan and Prem Ratan Dhan Payo's release. Salu Bhai has specifically said he wants the story to be fresh and different. If it is Salman, then there are going to be the Bang dialogues and a Bollywood kick to his performance. So how would it be different? Well, let us see what the sequel king is planning for us. What say? Bollywood's richest dude Shah Rukh Khan has been slowly making his presence felt on the TV screen. He who started his career with a memorable show Fauji is now shooting for India Puchega Sabse Shana Kaun that premieres next month. In the middle of the shoot, King Khan was asked to be a part of another show, not in a physical sense but by lending his voice to a historical serial Razia Sultan. And the king of romance sat and quizzed the crew for some time. He did this to understand the show and immediately got accustomed to the diction and dialect needed. Nice. The makers of Razia Sultan wanted him as a sutradhar or what you call it, a narrator to speak, because his voice is easily recognizable and will connect with audiences everywhere. We wonder what Shah Rukh will do next. Who said that success does not go into one's head? Take the example of an actress who turned a great drama queen recently. Our Khufiya Jasoos has come up with this news that our own Queen Kangana has turned down an offer playing Geeta Fogat, the daughter of famed wrestler Mahavir in Aamir's biopic Dangal. Well, that's quite something, Hannah, to turn down an Aamir flick. Even though Kangana claims she was not offered the role, Grapevine has something different to tell. Well, we are on for Tapsi after her stellar performance in Baby. So, yahi hai right choice kya is a doubt for we wonder how Tapsi could play a wrestler. It's an Aamir flick, so anything can work, what say? Remember we told you how the director of Sushant Singh Rajput starrer MS Dhoni The Untold Story, Neeraj Pandey was planning to release a tributary song for the Team India amidst ICC World Cup 2015? Well, the teaser of his much-awaited song Fir Se has been released and it is indeed impressive. Coming to the song, well, the song will surely stir up your patriotic feelings as the lyrics are quite inspiring. The music is catchy, full of desi beats and very thumping. So at least from the teaser, Fir Se looks like a perfect tribute anthem for Team India. All said and done, the makers of the film have done a good job with a song that's dedicated to the men in blue, aka the defending champions. So peeps, without wasting any more time, check out the teaser video and let us know what you think. After toasting the success of Hero Panti, Tiger Shroff has decided to sign another film, Baghi, that's being helmed by UTV Motion Picture and Sajid Nadiadwala. Jackie Shroff's beta won several accolades for his performance and we also hear that he has signed a movie opposite Aashiqui 2 actress Shraddha Kapoor. Baghi will be Tiger's second release after Hero Panti and the release date for the new film has been slated for next year. Under the direction of Sabir Khan, the Hero Panti actor will play the male lead. Our little birdie tells us that Baghi offers a lot of promise and the film's leading lady has not been decided yet, but we hear that a new lady will be getting her Bollywood debut with this one. Do you think it will be an exciting reunion considering the success of Tiger's debut? Are you excited for the Tiger's film? After Russell Peters, Pooja Bhatt has lashed out at Aamir Khan with regard to his comments about the AIB roast of Ranveer Singh and Arjun Kapoor. Yes, the actress who starred with Aamir in Dil Hai Ki Manta Nahi called him dangerous and hypocritical in an interview. Pooja, whose half-sister Alia attended the All India Bagchod roast and has a FIR lodged against her, she feels such cases are frivolous and absurd cases filed by bullies to trouble people and waste the time of the courts. Eek. Here's what she said. Aamir has completely forgotten his body of work, the double-meaning song Bhag DK Bose from Delhi Belly and the PK poster where he left nothing to the imagination, putting Sunny Leone to shame. Deepika Padukone has charmed millions with her acting chops. In fact, she's one such actress who has delivered maximum number of hits in the past 2 years. But there's more to this dimpled lady, it seems. Why do we say? Well, if rumors are to be believed, Dippy Baby is now gearing up to showcase her vocal skills. Yes, the Bajirao Mastani hottie is apparently planning to lend her voice for Tamasha, that's directed by Imtiaz Ali and co-stars Ranbir Kapoor. What's more is that Dip's darling might croon the number along with musical genius A.R. Rahman. Well, the reason why the B-Tan beauty met the Oscar-winning composer is that she's actually thinking of singing a song for the movie. Guess Shraddha Kapoor and Alia Bhatt aren't the only actresses bitten by the singing bug. Now we know what was really cooking on Farah Khan's food show, Farah Ki Daawat. Gautam Gulati seemed indifferent and preoccupied in the initial days of Big Boss till he had a flare-up with Karishma Tanna. Suddenly, he was attracted towards one of the Bollywood diva, Alia Bhatt. Yes, Gautam and Alia Bhatt were on a selfie spree on Farah's show. And while they were on the show, we saw Gautam proposing to Alia. This is a dream come true for Gulati, as he was earlier quoted in an interview saying, "Ideally, I wouldn't want to marry an actress, but if it's Alia Bhatt, I will." Now that he has proposed to Alia, has Cupid struck? Well, we don't know about that yet, but all we know for now is that the two will be showing off their culinary skills on Farah Ki Daawat.